So I tried an alternative to Adobe Photoshop called ACDSee Photo Studio Ultimate to retouch my photos. And let me tell you, the results were amazing. Okay, let me show you. So I have a few photos here. I'm going to try and improve these photos. But before I do that, let's start by retouching this photo. I'm in ACDSee here. And on top here, we have Manage. From this tab is where you're going to load your photos in Photo Studio Ultimate. If I maybe select this photo and then I double click on it, it's going to open in view mode here. Or I can just maybe select this photo and then I click on view here. So the photo is going to open in the view mode here. So I'm going to start by retouching this photo. I'm going to double click on it like this. So it's going to open in view mode. So I'm going to go to this tab, the develop tab here. I feel like the image is a little bit underexposed. And I want to fix that before I start retouching this photo. So I'm going to go this side. I'm just going to click on this plus sign here to open the masking here. I'm just going to click on this. So we have these AI buttons here. What I want to do is just to make my model a little bit brighter. I'm going to select this, select subject. I'm just going to left click on it. The Photo Studio has selected my subject here, but it has left this part. So I'm going to use the brush. The brush is already selected. So I'm just going to paint the place that I want to add to my selection. So I'm going to paint here to just add this part to my selection like this. I'm not going to paint the background because I don't want to select the background. So I'm going to go here. So this is where I'm going to control the size of the brush, the pressure and the feather of the brush. So I'm going to select this. I'm going to drag it this side. The size of the brush is changing there. So I'm going to make it just a little bit smaller like this. And then I'm going to just refine my selection here. Like that. From here, I'm going to go on exposure here. I'm just going to brighten my subject just a little bit. So I'm going to drag this side. I'm just adding the exposure to my subject. I don't want it to be on the background. So I'm going to take it to maybe plus 1.5. So if I want, I can maybe add the contrast to this image just a little bit, maybe like this. I'm going to drag this down here. So we have the white balance here. So if I want to make this image a little bit cooler, I'm going to drag this side. If I want to make it a little bit warmer, I'll take it this side. But the white balance is okay. So I'm going to reset this. I'm just going to close this. So this is the only thing that I wanted to do here, just to make my subject a little bit brighter. So I'm going to click on done here. Just click on save here. So from here, I'm just going to go to edit here. So now I'm in edit mode. So I'm going to try and retouch this photo here. To zoom in, I can just go on this slider here. Can drag it like this to zoom in. Or drag it down to zoom out like this. And then I can use the hand to just bring it down like this. Let me just close this. So I'm going to go on AI here. I'm going to select face edit here. Okay, so let me just zoom out a little bit. Okay, so let's start by removing the blemishes. Okay, before I do that, let me just try and play with these sliders and see if I'm going to like anything from here. So I'm going to select the face width. Like that. Okay, so with this one, I'm just going to leave it the way it is. I'm going to reset it by clicking on this icon here. Let's try jawline. Nope, this one, no. Okay, so I think I'm not going to do anything with these sliders. Let me just reset it here. So I feel like this eye is just a little bit smaller compared to this one. I don't know, but I feel like it's just a little bit smaller. Let's see if we can try to make it a little bit bigger. So I'm going to go on this chain here, the chain icon here. I'm just going to break it by clicking on it. I'm going to drag this slider this side. Let me just take it to maybe plus 10, I think somewhere here. And then what else can I do from here? Let's try the eye whitening. So the effect is subtle. It's not that much. Let's just move down here. So I'm only interested here in the skin retouching down here, but let's see what's going to happen if we try to play with these sliders. Let me just open the eyebrows. If I take it here, let me just reset this. Okay, I don't like what's happening here. Let me just reset this. Okay, let me just move to skin here. So on the skin here, we have smooth wrinkles here. Let me just take it here. Let me just zoom in a little bit like this. Let me just move it down here. So it's removing the wrinkles here. Let me just take it to zero and see what's happening here like this. And then let me take it to 100% like that. So I'm just going to like to find the balance, maybe somewhere around 35%. And then let's move to this slider and see what's going to happen. Okay, so it's making this part here a little bit darker. I don't want that. So I'm going to just reset this. So let's move to smoothening here. If I take it to 100%, it's making my model's skin smooth. This is too much for my liking, so I'm going to just reduce it to maybe 35%. Let's move to mouth here. Let's try to like to move the smile slider here. It's making my model smile. I don't want that. I'm going to reset this. Okay, let's move to makeup here. So let's move the lip saturation this side. Okay, the brush. So it's adding the brush here. Let's try upper eyeshadow. Okay, so it's adding the eyeshadows. Let me take it to zero. Okay, I think I'm okay with this. I don't want to like to overdo the editing here. So I'm just going to click okay here. So I'm going to go down here and then I'm going to select a curve and then I can push this down and then I'm going to move this up just a little bit and then I'm going to take this down. Okay, so there are so many things that I can do here to improve this image, but I feel like this is okay. I can work with this image. So one notable distinction from Adobe Photoshop is that with ACDSee Photo Studio, you have the option to purchase the license and the software for a one-time fee. So alternatively, if you prefer, you can just opt in for monthly subscriptions. So if you want to try ACDSee out, I'll put the link in the video description below that you can use to download this software. So let me move to this image here. What I can do to improve this image is to just maybe make it a little bit sharper. I'm going to go down here and then I'm going to select sharpening here. On the amount here, I'm going to take it this side. Let me just click on the face because I want the face to show here. I'm going to reduce the amount to maybe 20%. I'm going to click done here. The other thing that I can do maybe is just to play with the background. I'm going to go to select background here. My background is now selected. I'm going to select the white balance and then I can just make my background just a little bit warmer if I want it to look like this, or cooler if I want it to look like this. Let me just try to find the balance. I think this side, the image is like popping. It looks like an AI generated image. I don't want to go overboard. Let me just try to leave it at 40. I'm going to click done here. I feel like this is enough. Let me just move to this image and then I'm going to go to edit. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a copy of this image. I'm just going to right click and then I'm going to select duplicate layer to make a copy of this layer. And then I'm going to go this side. I'm going to select sky replacement here. I'm going to left click on it. So if you want, you can import your own sky by clicking on this icon. I'm just going to cancel here and then I'm going to use the ones that comes with the software. So I'm going to go on category here. I'm going to left click here. I can start with this folder. So we have blue skies here. I want something dramatic. So I'm going to go on category here and then I'm going to go to sunset. I can just go through these skies here. I'm going to use this one. If I want to make it bigger, I can just drag this slider like this. If I want to move it up and down, I can just use this slider. If I want to move it left or right, I can just use this slider here. So I'm going to put it somewhere here and then I'm going to go down here and then I'm going to just click done here. What I'm going to do from here, I'm going to zoom in just a little bit like this. I'm going to go down here. I'm going to add a layer mask by clicking on this icon here. I'm going to go up here and then I'm going to select the brush and then I'm just going to paint where I don't want this effect to be like this. Okay, so this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. Let me just fix this part. Then I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller like this. Let me just zoom in a little bit. So this is the before, this is the after, this is the before, this is the after. I love this. There are so many things you can do in ACDSee Photo Studio. I'm still learning how to use this software, and so far I like it and I'll keep using it. So if you want to try ACDSee out, I'll put the link in the video description below that you can use to download this software. And if you want to see how I shot these photos, you should check this video here.